Dear Tyrone, I hate your stinking guts. You're the scum beneath my toes. All right, so what do you guys do when you hate your spouse's stinking guts? And when you guys are maybe arguing about the same thing for the umpteenth time that you continue to, whether it's mother-in-laws, what, parent-in-laws, okay? Or anything that you know you may have in your marriage, what do you do when you keep getting gridlocked and you find yourself in those situations where you hate each other's stinking guts, all right? This is what you do, and this is what studies have proven to work. Number one, sleep in your own bed, okay? Go to your bed, go to sleep. Don't sleep in the couch, don't sleep in the kids' room. Sleep in your own bed. Number two, say, I apologize. It's okay, it's your spouse you wanna be vulnerable with. I apologize. Figure out maybe where you could have worked on to, or something you could do better in. So say, I apologize, will you forgive me? Number three is to treat your spouse the same way that you would treat a guest, or offer your spouse the same service you would offer a guest. If a guest came over to your house and they forgot their umbrella, you're gonna say, hey, you forgot your umbrella, and you're gonna give them their umbrella. However, sometimes with our spouses, we said, you freaking turd, you forgot your umbrella again, you're so forgetful, right? And we get so upset, but I wanna challenge you to offer that same service that you would to a guest, offer that to your spouse, and see how much you guys will find yourselves on the up and up with your marriage.
Yeah. All right, guys, so listen, hopefully, man, we're praying that this information is gonna bless you, bless your marriage, to keep it Christ-centered, and hopefully to go the distance. All right, so we love you guys. Yeah. See you next week. Do us a huge, huge favor. Leave a comment and share the video if you can. Love you guys.